One of the most well-known theories concerning the death of the dinosaurs argues that these ancient creatures went extinct when a large stone from space slammed into Earth. Through a series of events, this ultimately led to the extinction of dinosaurs. You've probably heard countless stories and hypotheses and movie plots regarding the disastrous consequences of an asteroid strike on Earth. But what exactly are asteroids? Where do they come from? And most importantly, could they really obliterate the entire planet if they were to strike Earth with enough force? An asteroid is a small, rocky object that orbits the Sun, just like the rest of the planets and celestial bodies in our solar system. Although asteroids are present throughout the solar system, most of them live in the asteroid belt, a region located between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. The size of objects within the asteroid belt have a wide range, from being no bigger than a dust particle to almost 1,000 kilometers wide. In fact, the largest asteroid present in the asteroid belt, Ceres, is 940 kilometers wide and is considered a dwarf planet. Although the asteroid belt hosts a multitude of asteroids, it's not the only region where these rocky objects hang around. Some asteroids are also found in the orbits of planets, which means that the planet and the asteroid circle the Sun on the same elliptical path. Earth and a few other planets have asteroids just like this. For some, a more interesting question is, how did these asteroids come into being? Our solar system came into existence about 4.6 billion years ago, when a large cloud of gas and dust collapsed. Following this event, most of that material fell to the center of the cloud, resulting in the formation of the Sun, the central star of our solar system. Planets were formed from some of the condensing dust in that cloud, but not all celestial material had the chance to be incorporated into planets. The leftovers from that time took on the form of asteroids. Asteroids vary greatly in terms of their shape and size. An asteroid can be as large as Ceres, nearly 1,000 kilometers wide, but on the other end of the spectrum, the smallest asteroid ever studied is a space rock called 2015 TC25. It's 2 meters wide and was observed when it made a close flyby of Earth in October of 2015. Almost all asteroids are irregularly shaped, although a few big ones, like Ceres, are nearly spherical. Asteroids are also cratered or pitted, and their surface is thought to be covered in dust. Asteroids orbit the Sun in elliptical orbits, but additionally, they also sometimes rotate, tumbling haphazardly through space. They may even have their own moons. We know of more than 150 asteroids that have a small companion moon, and some have more than one. Asteroids are found in three main regions of our solar system. A significant amount of asteroids are found in the asteroid belt, which lies between Mars and Jupiter. Then there are Trojan asteroids, a large group of asteroids that share the orbit of planets around the Sun. Jupiter Trojans are the most well-known and numerous of this variety. The total number of Jupiter Trojans larger than 1 kilometer in diameter is believed to be about 1 million. Finally, there are near-Earth asteroids, or NEAs. These circle closer to Earth than they do to the Sun. It is believed that nearly 10,000 of all known asteroids are NEAs. Asteroids are known to be composed of clay and rocks, as well as metals like nickel and iron. Now, since some asteroids are very close to Earth in comparison to other celestial bodies, is it possible for them to slam into our planet? Absolutely. Ever since Earth came into being, it has been struck relentlessly by asteroids and comets. In fact, the most popular theory regarding the extinction of dinosaurs is related to an asteroid that slammed into Earth, causing widespread destruction and obliterating most life forms in the global aftermath. Although many celestial objects approach our planet, a significant number of them get burned up in the atmosphere and never make it to Earth's surface. According to NASA, space rocks smaller than 25 meters will most likely burn up as they enter our atmosphere. However, some larger asteroids do make it through the atmosphere and impact our planet's surface. In 2013, an asteroid slammed into the atmosphere over the Russian city of Chelyabinsk. The shockwave created by this event injured 1,200 people. An asteroid capable of causing a global apocalypse would have to be more than 400 meters wide. Impact from such an asteroid would cause massive destruction of both life and property on a global scale. Fortunately, asteroids that huge strike Earth on average about once every 1,000 centuries. All in all, asteroids can and do orbit near our planet, but most will never approach Earth, And even if they do, they usually get burned up in the atmosphere long before making contact with our planetary surface. If you like this video, then please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more animated stories on the science in our lives. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us.